Ladies and gentlemen, during the Second World War, the school was evacuated, and the pupils moved to Carlion Bay in Cornwall so that their educations could continue without compromising their safety. In 2020, we evacuated again to Microsoft Teams. Our school has stood since 597 AD, and with all of the different eras and challenges it's faced, this is far from the first time that it has had to adapt. It survived bombings, conflicts, and now COVID. You don't become the oldest continuously running school if you're easily derailed. Whilst the institution stands firm, I know that many of us feel overwhelmed in the face of such global upheaval. We will never forget the trials of 2020. Moving online has been a huge change for us, and although we miss seeing each other in person, the adjustment to this system has been admirable. For me, that's what the last few months have shown. Our ability to adapt and to be resilient, globally, individually, and as a school community. The philosopher Heraclitus supposedly said that the only thing that is constant is change. I personally have changed a lot during my time at King's, having joined as a 5-foot soprano, but I've never before experienced such changes as those brought about by 2020. If you had told me last September that over the following months, there'd be an escalation in global tensions, there would be no public exams, and Galpins would yet again fail to place in house song, I'm not sure I would have believed you. But the unimaginable can happen, and we have to adapt. I'm genuinely proud to be a part of a community which has adapted to the recent challenges with such optimism. Both the teachers and the students have embraced the virtual world, and it's been great to have had a continued engagement with the school through online classes. The success of virtually King's Week shows an enduring sense of positivity and community within the school, although I will never quite get used to receiving a whole school email with TikTok in the subject line. It could only have been achieved with the engagement of the pupils, and I find it heartening that even in our current situations, people are taking the time to spread some joy. This energy does not seem forced, but to have stemmed from a place of maintained hope. There's an Albert Camus quotation which I think demonstrates this. In the depths of winter, I finally learned that within me there lay an invincible summer. To me, this is about facing external challenges and discovering resilience. I'd like to thank the head man, the senior leadership team, and the chaplains for the direction that they give. I've been continually struck by the level of care that goes into the running of the school, and it's no mean feat for the head man to know every student at an individual level. I hope that people took advantage of the opportunity to thank their teachers last week. There have been so many teachers who have helped me and inspired me, and I think it's worth just taking a minute to reflect and to show your gratitude. The support staff are also integral to the success of the school. So, to the cleaning staff, the caterers, the matrons, gardeners, and everyone else, who has made King's a uniquely warm and beautiful place to live as well as to study. Thank you. We've been lucky to have such excellent vice captains in Gabe and Flo. Their proactivity and insight have been indispensable. To all of the Purples, you've been wonderful. Thank you for your hard work. Where the robe could have been perceived as a reward, thank you for viewing it as a commitment. Now, as our current 6As move from being pupils to OKS, our thoughts turn back to the future. It remains uncertain whether we will immediately be able to continue with our plans for further education or gap years, but whilst the year ahead for us is uncertain, the future is looking bright. with such academic potential, ambition, and conviction, this isn't just a year group that will experience change, but action it. I look forward to our commemoration day next June so that we can regroup and catch up. So now, as we move into our futures and the school moves into its, I would like to follow in the tradition of handing over my gown. Ideally, I'd be able to do this in person, but this seems the next best thing. Daisy, having chatted with you for a couple of hours yesterday, I know that the school couldn't be in better hands. I just hope that you and your fellow Purples enjoy it as much as we have. This is yours, and I will get it to you somehow. My parting piece of wisdom, if I have any, is to appreciate your teachers and your friends. If there's anything that I've come to realize over the past few months, it's that I've found myself missing the people at King's the most and have relied heavily on staying in contact online. I've known some of my friends here since I was 4 years old, and I hope that the bonds that I have made will last a lifetime. I will miss letting off some steam in debating and spending the evenings speaking with the tutors and the boys in house. But most of all, I will miss getting up and going to lessons and just seeing people that I'd seen the day before and feeling that I was amongst friends. Change is inevitable, but we can never really predict when it will occur. If any good is to come of the last few months, it may be the realization of how much we mean to and miss each other. It's clearer than ever that we need to cherish the bonds we have and take every opportunity that comes our way. Just as the evacuees returned to King's after the war, so will we be restored to the campus once again. Be it a return to normal lessons, or a final goodbye for the 6As, it'll be a great day when we come back to King's. I look forward to hopefully seeing you all soon. Be safe, and I hope you have a great summer. Thank you.